elementary school teacher, insane, used a chokehold on a student. And she's not the only one. Let's put the picture up full mass. Math coach Stefanie Sanabria has stepped down from her position at the Brookside Elementary School in Connecticut after police arrested her because, according to her, she demonstrated a chokehold maneuver on three different students and she caused one of them to lose consciousness. Okay? The incident with the student occurred last month, although the teacher was only arrested and charged for it on Friday. Her bond was set at $20,000 and she has a court appearance coming up Friday. The teacher has since been hit with charges of second degree strangulation, first degree reckless endangerment, and risk of injury to a minor. That's according to the local police. The student who passed out was treated by a school nurse and did not suffer any permanent injury. Let me give you another similar incident. Let's put the picture up. This is Mika Deloach. A Houston teacher's aide is now wanted by authorities because she allegedly choked a 5-year-old student. They said the incident happened on September 2nd, 2022, when Deloach was a teacher's aide at Beatrice Mays Institute last April in New York. A New York school teacher is facing multiple charges after allegedly choking a 12-year-old student. Chester Hingle, 45 years of age, is charged with endangering the welfare of a child and criminal obstruction of breathing, according to the NYPD. The incident happened at IS 2017 School of Performing Arts, where Hingle allegedly choked the child for roughly 5 seconds. Also in New York, this happened in December. An elderly substitute teacher was busted for choking a Queens Middle School student during class. The victim told police he was in his 5th period class and walking to the garbage to throw out an item when the class sub, Vernon Jerome, 77, suddenly put his hands around the kid's throat and held on for about 5 seconds, authorities said. The boy did not report any injuries and was not hospitalized. The teacher was arrested and charged with criminal obstruction of breathing and acting in a manner injurious to a child. That's just the tip of the iceberg. You have to agree. I don't care what political ideology you may subscribe to. You have to agree, choking children is a no-no, right? Okay. When are Republican lawmakers going to present some kind of legislation in order to remedy that issue? See, this is a real problem. It's actually happening all across the country. They want you to think that the biggest evil is critical race theory, or perhaps an advanced class in African American studies, or having conversations about members of the LGBTQ community. These are distractions, typically. What they're trying to do is create a scenario that's a cultural dynamic rather than a true policy dynamic. Real children are being impacted adversely by criminal conduct of teachers. The answer from Governor Ron DeSantis in Florida is what? To make it a third degree felony for a teacher to bring an unapproved book into the classroom. This is what they're doing with your money. Making up ridiculous ass laws when real children are suffering. At some point, this has to come to a head, right? We have to actually get back to the policy dynamic, protecting children. The best way to do so. All right, Sharon, thoughts here.
I'm at a loss, Dr. Yeah. Richey. I did till the student was unconscious. Three students and one had to fall unconscious, be treated by the nurse. And you mentioned Florida. I don't know what the penalty would be for bringing that book into the classroom. Her bond, though, in Connecticut for choking out the kid, $20,000. And I don't even know if she's turned herself in yet. Okay. This is astonishing to me. We need good teachers, and now perhaps they'll have to sign on the dotted line that they will not choke out their student.
Yeah, and unfortunately, and I hate to say this, but it's true, some teachers don't get reported because of that good old boy network that exists in the community. All right, we'll follow these stories as they develop.